and I'm with the Vice Chairman of the Jubilee Party, David Murathe, as well as the Senator of Nairobi, Johnson Sakaja. Chemutai, take it over from there.
Well, Jubilee Party Vice Chair David Murathe, you're here for the 57th Jamhuri Day celebrations. What are you celebrating?
We're celebrating the milestones. We are celebrating the achievements. We are celebrating the 10 years, 9 of this presidency. We are proud to see that they have actually implemented most of the manifesto pledges that we gave in 2013. We have connected more power, we've built more roads, we've connected more water than all the previous administrations combined. Now, so today is going to be like a scorecard, fact check about the achievements of the Jubilee government and the Jubilee administration.
In the last address by the president, he seemed to have touched a little bit on, you know, his administration's successes, what he's been able to do in terms of infrastructure, in terms of the economy, the GDP is doing well. But there were a lot of questions about Kenya's debt levels. And of course, over the years, there's been increased borrowing. Maybe touch on something regarding what the president could speak in terms of that.
There's nobody who is ever going to give you money unless they are sure that you can repay it. The other issue people need to deal with is, what is this borrowing for? Is it for consumption or is it for infrastructure? Now, the borrowing that has gone into this country is borrowing for infrastructure. You have seen the kind of infrastructure that has been done by this administration over the last 8-9 years. All the corners of this country have been opened up. Malindi, Lamu, Kisumu, Kakamega, you name it. And once you create that enabler, because once you have all the roads in place, once you have power reaching out to the local markets and the villages, you get people doing all kinds of work. There are welders happening, there are people doing windows, doors. These are the enablers that have been created by the so-called borrowing. And our debt level is not unsustainable. It is sustainable. And once you have borrowed to do a road, you will not borrow again. That road can only become an enabler for people, for example, from Nyandarua, to deliver their milk to the market. Before, it used to be thrown to the dogs. Today they can drop their potatoes and whatever to the market, their cabbages and all that. So people need to see the bigger picture.
You made some very strong statements a few days ago at Kasarani during, you know, the conference that was on, the Azimio la Umoja conference. Political undertones expected over the years, 9 years, the relationship between the president and his deputy has soured.
My friend, nobody has ever become president in this republic until you have become the leader of the opposition. Uhuru was a leader of opposition. Kibaki was a leader of opposition. Moi was a leader of opposition when he was in Kadu. The deputy president, even Raila, has been leader of opposition. There's nobody who becomes president in this country until you have been leader of the official opposition.
Enough said, enough said.
Every time probably people see you on TV, they see a lot of political fireworks. Mm-hmm. The other time I heard you say it's the silly season, the political silly season. Why would you say so? And wouldn't it also be wise to let Kenyans make their decisions at the ballot on their choices when the elections are called next year?
It's a silly season because you see a lot of movement. You see a lot of shifts and, you know, dances. At the end of the day, it is who will make that decision. But you have to root for your own candidates. You have to get to a position where you tell them, if it were you, this is the way you would go. For example, we are asking Kenyans either to choose Baba or Alibaba. These are things you root for in your campaigns.
Asante sana, David Murathe, Vice Chairman of the Jubilee Party.